In Madison County, leaders of Sugar City, Rexburg, and the county are considering plans to build two separate five-lane roads east of their towns. This isn't the expansion of an existing road, so if commissioners pass it, they will have to use eminent domain and buy currently owned private properties. One particular homeowner is concerned about losing her home because one of the projected roads goes right through her house. And taking action for you, Eyewitness News reporter Stephen Pope joins us. Stephen, Madison County growing, everybody knows that. But are these roads really necessary?
Well, Todd, city and county leaders feel like they are and cite bumper-to-bumper traffic congestion along 2nd East as proof. If the county continues to grow in its current pace and they don't act now, those leaders say there could be serious consequences. But that isn't any consolation to Linda Kajex's family because one of the proposed roads goes right through her home. As you can imagine, she's rather distraught about it.
I can't even tell you how it made me feel. It made me feel devastated. I want to know why would all this planning going on without any of us knowing about it? Why weren't the property owners consulted?
There are two proposed roads that would connect Rexburg and Sugar City through Barney Dairy Road at both 1000 and 2000 East. While the exact locations of both of these roads is still being debated, Sugar City has endorsed the East Parkway corridor and also recommended a beltway. That beltway would go straight through Linda Kajex's home.
Who makes these decisions about what home gets to be left and why this one has to be destroyed?
John, who ultimately makes the decision on this project?
The majority of the project lies within the impact zone of the cities of Rexburg and Sugar. And when that happens, our understanding is that the decision lies with the county commissioners.
The cities, the county, and the Idaho Transportation Department have all identified a need for new roads in the area.
Right now, if you travel 2nd East at particular times of the day, there's bumper-to-bumper traffic.
John, do you feel like the governments of the cities and the county have been transparent about their desire to move forward with this plan?
Oh, absolutely. You know, this has been going on for some time now, and a number of public input meetings have been held. It's well documented.
In a letter from Sugar City to Madison County dated May 26, it reads, "We propose placing these corridors on our comprehensive plan maps now. Identifying them on our maps would enable planning and zoning commissions, developers, and residents to better plan their affairs and invite federal aid for future project design and construction." But it wasn't until just recently that the Kajex family learned of these plans, and they took their concerns to Mayor Glenn Dalling.
Said, "What's this about a map with a road going right through our house? Is this something we need to be worried about?" And they said, "Oh, we're just straightening up the office right now. We can't find the map, and it's no big deal. This is something that's 30, 40 years down the road. Everybody will be dead and gone before this ever comes to pass, and it might not ever."
These plans will likely become more transparent on Monday when county commissioners will hold a public hearing to discuss the first of those two projects. If you want to get involved with this issue, it starts at 5 p.m. in the commissioner's room at the Madison County Courthouse.
It sounds like an issue that will impact there's the county, the homeowners. I mean, we're talking for years to come.
Absolutely, Todd. It is, and we'll be sure to continue to follow that.
Okay. Stay on top of it. Stephen, thanks a lot.